How do you best pick the colors to work harmoniously together in your artwork? In April, I published a video about color psychology. To boil it all down, I talk about how colors, their effect, and associations help drive your story along. For example, if your artwork is meant to invoke a sense of melancholy, you might pick blues and purples. This video, however, is about how colors interact with each other on a surface visual level. There are 7 relationships, and I'm going to simplify them the way that I, as a self-taught artist, found easiest to retain and put into practice. Relationship number 1, monochrome. This means that your artwork is made of one singular color. You can use different hues and shades, but it must still be within the same color. Number 2, analogous. These colors are neighbors. You can use 2 or more colors, but the effect is best seen with a maximum of 4 colors. Number 3, complementary. This is also commonly referred to as contrasting colors. They are directly in front of each other. Because of how different they are to each other, they are visually appealing to see together. Split complementary, also called compound, is a subcategory of contrasting colors. This means there is one color at one side, but 2 in front of it. If you trace the shape on the color wheel, it will look like the letter Y. Number 4, triad. These are 3 colors that are social distancing, 3 spaces apart, and in the shape of a triangle if you trace them on the color wheel. Number 5, tetrad. These are 4 colors that social distance 2 spaces between them. At the end, you will have 2 sets of complementary colors. If you trace them on the color wheel by their spaces, you will create a square. But if you trace them by their complementary colors, you will have the letter X. Number 6, neutral. This relationship is about desaturated colors. Any and all, as long as they are neutral. Number 7, random. As the name suggests, it's just picking whatever colors and arranging a marriage between them in the hopes that they're good together in the end. And that's it. These are all the relationships between colors. Because I'm a visual learner, tracing them in the color wheel is definitely the easiest way I found to learn and apply these concepts. The artwork I'm working on here is from April of 2023 and is a Draw This In Your Style challenge hosted by R. Pierre on Instagram. I apologize if I'm mispronouncing. The link to their Instagram will be on the description box. Because of the nature of this illustration, the color palette was chosen by the original artist, but I did make a few adjustments of my own. The colors, apart from the red, are desaturated. I did not use pink and instead made my own addition of blue. In the end, the relationship between colors in my rendition of this artwork is a split complementary, with red being the lone wolf on one side and the green and blue being one space apart in front of the red. The skin color and hair are also red, but they are different hues. I'm not the first person to talk about this subject, and I'm sure I won't be the last. But I hope the way I simplified it for myself can be of any help for you. Thank you for tuning in. Click on the white subscribe button down below. You will know when you are subscribed when it turns from white to gray. Have a magical day.